students, last video we already discussed about how the other South Indian who are the famous leaders, kings or dynasty came and what was the achievements they had done. So these are the matters we had discussed in last video. So in this video we are discussing next another important topic. So that is here they given. In Karnataka, some of the local important rulers, they have their own culture, own tradition, own language. So that on that based we can some of the important rulers in Karnataka, especially in Karnataka. They are some of the important local rulers also in our region. So in that report only we are discussing in this video. So in this chapter we are discussing on that based of there are four important rulers in Karnataka, means local rulers. So first one we are discussing about Kodagu, second one we are discussing about Kitturu, after that Tulu Nadu and Hyderabad. So in that region's places, who are the kings they came, what was the achievements they done, and what was the, any contribution they given? Yes, say they given some of the contribution. So these are the matters we are discussing in this video. So in that first one, we want to know about the information of Kodagu. Kodagu also one of the important dynasty in Karnataka. So they also given so much of contribution in the field of language or tradition. And not only this one, we can say in the best of nation, means our nation for also they give us so much of contribution. So in that matters, we are discussing. So first of all, we want to know in which place or which direction or which region in we can see this one place, Kodagu. So this Kodagu, we can see this place in the slopes of Western Ghats. In the slopes of Western Ghats, we can see in the name of or in the district of Kodagu. And next one here they are saying, yeah, who are the peoples they are living in this region? Commonly they are speaking language of Kodava and Aribashi. Commonly who are they living in Kodagu district peoples or Kodagu region peoples? They are speaking commonly there are two languages. One is Kodava and second one is Aribashi. And we can see one of the important river in Karnataka. Most of the peoples in that river only they are drinking. You see, this is a lifeline of Karnataka, this river, that is river Kaveri. The Kaveri birthplace is in Kodagu. That birthplace name is Tala Kaveri. And still now, there are so many people, still now they are worshipping as a god, this one place, the place of, the birthplace of Kaveri, that is Tala Kaveri. And Kodagu district, this is one of the very rich wealth in the place of, or in the sector of forest. We can see most of the area is covered by dense forest. We can see in the place of Kodagu. And here one of the important park, national park also we can see, that is Nagaravale National Park. So these are the common matters, common things. What are the main features we can see about Kodagu? One is this region located in Western Ghats slopes. And second one, we can see these peoples, they are speaking in that region, people they are speaking Kodava and Aribashi. And another one we have discussed, one of the important rivers flowing or birthplace we can see in the place of Kodagu, that is Kaveri River. The birthplace is Tala Kaveri. Still now there are so much of peoples, they are worshipping still that place. And not only this one, we can see in this region is rich in the forest area. And one of the important park we can see in that region, that is Nagaravale National Park. So these are the common matters about Kodagu district. So now we want to know about the historical matters. So any peoples they came, they given any contribution, or in British ruling time, if they did any struggles. So these matters now we want to should study. So when we are discussing about the history of Kodagu district, so we want to know in the beginning this region is ruled by Alari dynasty. So here they say in Kodagu, when you are discussing about the district of Kodagu or region of the Kodagu, so we want to know about the dynasty of Alari. This is one of the ancient dynasty ruled in the place of Kodagu. They ruled in the century of 17th century. Here they saying this Alari dynasty founded by or established by Veera Raja. Here they saying Veera Raja founded by Kodagu dynasty or Alari dynasty. After that, here one of the important person came, Muduraja. He built a new city. So in that city for the given name as a Muduraja Keri. So this only he made as a capital. Who Muduraja. He built one of the new city. In that city, for the given name as a Mudurajakeri. So this Mudurajakeri only become as a Madikeri. So now we are understood how the name of Kodagu or how the name of Kodagu for Madikeri name became because of one of the important person Muduraja. After the Viraraja, Viraraja is a founder of Halari dynasty. So after that Muduraja came, he built one of the new city, a new place, that is Mudurajakeri. So in that Mudurajakeri only become as a Madikeri. So that like they say. So after that, after the these kings, after, so one of the new dynasty emerged in Mysuru dynasty, in Mysuru region. So that is Hyder Ali and Tipu Sultan. They started to rule in the place of Mysuru Odiyars. They replaced in the place of Mysuru Odiyars, and they captured the place and they started to rule. So in that time, Tipu Sultan, he captured Hyder Ali and Tipu Sultan in this during time, they captured by Kodagu dynasty. In beginning, the Kodagu region is ruled by Halari dynasty, but later when Hyder Ali and Tipu Sultan, they came in power in Mysuru region, so on that time both also they captured the region of Kodagu. So when they captured the region of Kodagu, on that time who is king of on that particular period or on that particular dynasty, in Halari dynasty, or the same way Viraraja. So Tipu Sultan given punishment to that Viraraja, that is prison. He kept in a prison. So after that, he escaped. Who escaped? Viraraja escaped in the prison and he asked the help of British. So when they asked the British, so British they given to help to Viraraja. With the support of British, they did war. So when the Tipu Sultan is died, after the death of Tipu Sultan, he is saying this region became is the under the control of Halari dynasty. And when they given the support to Halari dynasty, British and Kodagu dynasty both also, means Halari dynasty both also, they kept good relations with each others. So that led they say. So now we are understood, that means in ancient time which dynasties came and what was the work they done. So one of the major dynasty came in Kodagu district, that is Halari dynasty. This one came in the century of 17th century, beginning of 17th century. Viraraja is a founder. Muduraja was one of the important person. But when Viraraja came, so on that time Tipu Sultan and Hyder Ali, they also became power in Mysuru region. So on that time they tried to capture the place of Kodagu, and they captured also. So when they captured, they given Viraraja for punishment as a to keep in a prison. So after that he escaped in the place of that prison, Viraraja. So when he escaped, he asked the help of British. So when the British given the support, so with the support of British, they did battle. So in that battling, Tipu Sultan is died. In the 4th Anglo-Mysore War, Tipu Sultan is died. So when he is died, so after that he has the saying, once again, Kodagu means Halari dynasty and British. So both also, they kept good relations. Because of on that time they given help, they given support to Halari dynasty. So in that based. So now we want to know after that how the relationship became good or bad afterwards. In beginning, in the period of Viraraja, they have good relationship. But after that, same relationship they continued or not. So that only now we want to know. So here they're saying, in the period of 1834, one of the important ruler ruled in the place of Halari dynasty. That person name is here, they saying by Chikka Veera Rajendra. So when he came to start the rule in that particular region, in the region of Kodagu, he decided that I want to rule directly in the place of Kodagu. Because of if any matters is going on in Kodagu regions, who are they interfering in that matters? British, they always interfering. But Chikka Veera Raja is not interested, these are the matters. So I want to rule as an independent in that particular dynasty. So when these like of thoughts came by Chikka Veera Rajendra, so here they saying, so in that time only British, they divided, here they saying, they divided Kodagu as a two part. One is Kodagu, second one is here they saying by Amarasulya. So Amarasulya, they divided and they kept in the district of Kenara. They added or they merged with the district of Kenara. So when these like of incident happened, so some of the peoples, they started revolt against British. Because of till that much time, this Amarasulya, this is a part of Kodagu. But when Chikkavira Rajendra, he decided this, like, of I want to become as an independent ruler, should not interfere any others in our dynasty's matters. So when this, like, of thoughts came, so in that time British, they thought that we want to divide the place of Kodagu. Otherwise, we could not get these are the place. Especially this Kodagu region. Because very wealth, and we can see thick forest, and we can see there are some of the plenty of water resources also we can see. So how they are living, British government. So they should, we want to divide the place of Kodagu as a two part. One is Amarasulya, another one remaining part as a Kodagu. So when these like of situations happen, so peoples of Kodagu, they started revolt because of this part of Kodagu, this Amarasulya. So why British they dividing? And not only this one, when the Amarasulya, they divided, and who are the workers, especially farmers, who are the farmers on that time in Amarasulya? So British government, they keep, they should, in that peoples who are the farmers, the adapted workers, the farmers, they want to pay heavy tax, heavy land tax. This one is burden to pay for farmers. Because of British government, what they saying, that one, the peoples and government, means dynasty, both also not listening. So that's why British government, what they thought, you want to implement any other policy or method. So on that base, here they saying, the British government implemented by one of the new land tax in the place of Kodagu, especially in Amarasulya. So that is heavy burden. Peoples, that much of capacity they not have, so they could not pay the money or tax. So when these like of situations happened, in 1837, the farmers of Amarasulya, they all have started struggle or revolt against British government. They started, you want to decide fight against British government. So when they started in 1837, so this only they give a name as a Amarasulya revolt. So in that Amarasulya revolt, conducted in different places, in the place of Puttur, Kasaragodu, Mangaluru, and Sulya. So in that four regions in peoples actively they participated in the revolt of Amarasulya. Because of to oppose that land tax. Because that is heavy. They fixed heavy tax. So this one could not pay that much of capacity they not have. So that's why the peoples or farmers they started struggle against British government. But they did, here they saying they did 13 days they did revolt against the British government. But successfully the British government they solved or they suppressed the revolt. And who are they started the rebels? So for them they given punishment also. So these like British government, when the Amarasulya peoples they started the struggle, so this one struggle, they actually means they used the ideas, so on that based they solved the problems of Amarasulya. So and they given some of the who are they started this one revolt, for them they given punishment also. And in that time, we can see there are three important leaders. They took the leadership in that revolt and they given so much of contribution and awareness to peoples. So who are the peoples they given this type of confidence or awareness to Kodagu dynasty peoples? Here they saying one is Puttabasappa, second one is Kalyana Swami, and third one Gudde Mane Appaya Goda. So these are the three members, they given ideas or suggestion to Kodagu peoples, how we want to do struggle or why we want to do the struggle and why this one is need, because of this is our dynasty. Why British government they want to interfere in these matters? Because of Chikkavira Rajendra, who are the king on that time, they kept, they did not give on the post of king. So Chikkavira Rajendra left the place and he went to Bangalore. And here no one, they are ruler, but basically this place under the control of Alari dynasty. But in middle time, British they interfere and they capture the place and they divide the place also. So when these like of matters going on, so Kodagu dynasty peoples, they started revolt, and on the time only British government they fixed heavy land tax also. When they fixed heavy land tax, this tax, that much of capacity they not have, so they started Amarasulya revolt. So after that now we want to know, this is how the relationship between British and Kodagu. Beginning is good, but after that, they did struggle or revolt. So next one we want to know, here in this Kodagu also, they given contribution about the freedom struggle time. So when Indian National Congress or freedom fighters, when they came, when they started the struggle, so on that time, Kodagu also, they given some of the support to freedom fighters who are there, for them they given support and they also participated. And next one here is saying, after independence, here they saying, this Kodagu is still a separate state. When India got independence, so on that time, Kodagu is not a part of Karnataka. So this is a separate state. So when we got the independent, sorry, you are saying after in 1956, when the language based state formations committee created, so when they given suggestions, so on that based Kodagu, this has become as a part of Karnataka. Till 1956, this Kodagu dynasty, this is a separate state. So that like they say, after independence, this Kodagu dynasty or Kodagu district, this is a separate state. So when 1956 language based committee they came, so when they established it, when they gave a report to central government, so on that based the Kodagu dynasty become the part of Karnataka. So that like they saying. So after that, next one point we want to know here, there are two important peoples or person we could not forget the name of these two members. They given so much of contribution to our nation, our country. So who are the members? So first one here they saying, one is general, here they given Kodendra Madappa Kariyappa. So this one of the important person, he came, he here they saying, in the period of British, so when they started to rule, so on that time he become first Indian general, here they saying, of Indian army. Is the first general of Indian army. So when they started British rule, so on that time is the first Indian general of Indian army. And not only this one, he is the first Indian general army of after independence also. Not only in any one force, land, air and navy, in the three force was also evenly general, Indian general. So on that, he is the head of in that particular force, in three force for us. And they actively they participated and effectively he developed the force of land, air and navy. And this is one of the symbol of this man, this Kariyappa, this one symbol of courage and bravery. So this much of strong person, and not only this one, he was got, he did given so much of contribution in the field of air, navy and land force. So that's why they given highest field marshal rank for him, for the Kariyappa, they given rank of field marshal because of his bravery and the courage. And he maintained successfully after independence, he maintained successfully the three force also. So this is one of the important person, that is K.M. Kariyappa. So after that, another person also came. He also given so much of contribution in the field of, he also given in the contribution field of in nation level for our country service, for only the given contribution. That person name is General K.S. Timmaya. So he is one of the important person. He also came in the Kodagu. He is one of the patriot of Kodagu as well as our country for also, and he was one of the important leader and one of the important general, because of when India and Pakistan they did battle, so on that time one of the important role lead by K.S. Timmaya. K.S. Timmaya is one of the important person in Kodagu dynasty, because of when the war conducted between India and Pakistan, so on that time he did important role. And he conducted or given good direction to soldiers. So on that based, India got victory also in that battles. So in that based of victory, some of the contribution given by K.S. Timmaya. So this both peoples also, one of the important identified peoples in Kodagu dynasty, in the based on military. And still now, not only in the field of military based, we can see in Kodagu dynasty peoples, they are famous in the sector of sports, adventure and folklore and scenic beauty. So in that base also we can see this region are very famous, not only for military based or only two members. No, we can see sports in also, there are so many people they came, and adventure, and we can see folklore and scenic beauty, we can see nature beauty also of the Kodagu. This is one of the beauty. and nature creativity also we can see in the place of Kodagu. So this like Kodagu, this is one of the important dynasty and Karnataka, and the rulers also came Alari dynasty. The founder of Alari dynasty is Veeraraja. So this was one of the important point, and we had discussed how Madikeri they came as a name. And next one we had discussed how the British and Kodagu, they have the good relationship. So this one also we had discussed. So after that, after independence, how the Kodagu dynasty merged with Karnataka. And last one we had discussed about, there are two important peoples in Kodagu dynasty. They came to India and means they given so much of contribution in for our nation in the sector of military. So these are the important points about Kodagu. So after that Kodagu, we want to know another important dynasty in south, especially in Karnataka. So that one here they given Kitturu. So this Kitturu, this is one of the important powerful state in Karnataka on that time. This is one of the powerful local leaders dynasty on that time. So this Kitturu present in, we can see, in the district of Belagavi. And this state ruled by around 2 centuries in our Karnataka region. Means totally 200 years they ruled in the place of Karnataka. And this region, one of the important, why this one region is very important, because of the field of agriculture and the commerce, means for the purpose of sector of business. So in that both for also, this Kitturu region are one of the important region. And now we want to know, so what was the achievements or why we want to study about the Kitturu? So they given any contribution in the field of freedom struggle time, or when they started British rule, so on that time, yes, they given some of the contribution. So especially here they saying, so Rani Chennamma, she is one of the bravery lady and one of the famous queen in the region of Kitturu. So why she is a very famous, or what was the achievement she done? So that one now we want to know. So here they say, Rani Chennamma of Kitturu, means she is ruled in the place of Kitturu. She was the wife of Mallasarja Desai. So Desai of the Kitturu. So in that family she came, means in that family she did. So on that time she leave, and she is also queen. So when Mallasarja and his son both also died for illness, some of the sick. So that's why both also died. Husband and his own son. So when the husband and own son they died, so after that this dynasty came and over to Rani Chennamma. So Rani Chennamma, so on that time she adopted one of the important child as a son. So that person name is here they given Shivalinga Sarja. So when Rani Chennamma adopted by Shivalinga Sarja as a son, so here they say one of the important British leader or collector in Dharwada region on that time, that person name is Thackeray, is seeing the situations. Because of on that time British government they implemented one of the new policy. So in based on the policy, we want to capture the different regions of India, we want to rule. So that's why Thackeray observing the situation, husband died, son also died, so now only one single lady are there in that particular dynasty, she is ruling, so easily we can capture the place. So that's why he given report to government of the British. So what he given report, Thackeray, the Dharwad collector. So he given report as a, so here in Kitturu, the place of the Kitturu, in that Kitturu king was died and his son also died. So now only Kitturu, Queen Chennamma, only she ruling in the place of Kitturu, and she adopted one of the son. But in our policy based, this facility or this rights we are not given to Queen Chennamma, because of we are implementing one of the new policy, doctrine of lapse. So on that based we want to capture the place of Kitturu, because there is no own son for Queen Chennamma, she adopted one of the important son. How we want to give for them as a power in the region of Kitturu, we want to capture this one place. So that like Thackeray, he given report to British government. So when they submitted this like of report, so this news heard by Queen Chennamma, and she seriously opposed this one policy. So when they opposed, so here they saying with the help of 500 soldiers, here they saying with the support of, here they saying with the support of soldiers, Queen Chennamma, she started battle against British government. So on that time British government took by leadership as a Thackeray with the army of 500 soldiers, he started battle against Queen Chennamma. So when they started battle against Chennamma, so both also they did battle. Chennamma is bravely, she did war. So in that war, Thackeray is died in a battlefield. So when they died by battlefield in Thackeray, so easily the Queen Chennamma, she won the battle. So when this news is heard by British government, after that, once again, they sent huge army to Kitturu dynasty. Because of one small lady or small dynasty, so she is defeated by our British government. Because of was one of the effective army force, how she defeated. So that's why when they news heard, so after that, they sent one of the huge army. Here in Kitturu side, they have only 6,000 soldiers. But they have huge army force. So in that place, when they started by battle, both team, one side Kitturu and another one side is British government. So when they started both also, so in that some of the peoples, British government, they given money. So and they given support of the local leaders. So with the help of the local leaders, British government easily they defeated by Kitturu, the queen of Chennamma. And they captured the place of Kitturu and they kept Chennamma for in the prison of Bailavangala. So when they kept this like of incident happened, in this place of prison only, she continued the war. She given some of the ideas or inspirations to common peoples. This is our region, why they want to capture, we want to do struggle. So that like of inspirations given in the prison also. But still, we can see the work or the achievements of Queen Chennamma, that is remarkable. Because of she is a single lady, a small dynasty, with the support of a small soldiers, only 6,000 soldiers are there in that particular dynasty. So with the support of 6,000 soldiers, she did war and bravely she defeated. And she killed by Thackeray also, one of the important collector on that time in Darbar region. So in history, this one is one of the remarkable incident. And she is the first woman, she did battle against British government. She is the first woman, she did battle against British government. So that's why still now, peoples, they are remarkable person, identified as a figure as a Queen Chennamma. She did that much of work. So we can see this like of achievements, we can see in the folk songs and also, we can see about the information. So after that in Kitturu Rani Chennamma or Queen Chennamma or in Kitturu Chennamma, here another person, he took the leadership and he also continued the revolt of Rani Chennamma's ideas or Queen Chennamma's ideas. So here they say Sangolli Rayanna is one of the important great follower, loyal follower or great follower of Queen Chennamma. So when he heard the news, this like Queen Chennamma, she did battle against British government, but the British government, they defeated and she kept for him as a infer, means she is kept in the prison in the place of Bailavangala. So when they heard the news, so here in Kitturu place, one of the important great follower of Queen Chennamma, that is Sangolli Rayanna, he took the leadership and he given awareness to common peoples. So this is our place, our motherland, why we want to give to British government. So these like he took the beliefs of common peoples, and with the support of common peoples of the local level, means in the Kitturu dynasty. So with the help of Kitturu dynasty, he started struggle against or revolt against British government. There are different types of war method. So he did guerrilla war method, and not only this one, he started to loot the British treasuries also. So if it's their wealth or weapons, he started to loot that one particular treasuries. So this like of works he conducted. So when this like of situations is going on in Kitturu place, so once again he take to British government. Because of in beginning Queen Chennamma, we have stopped that one revolt. But once again another person came now. So he also doing that like only work. So now British government, they thinking we want to stop this one rebel anyway. But they searching to Sangolli Rayanna, he did not get any place. So when he did not get in any place, so they used another different ways. So are their local levels people, are their local leaders are there on the time in Kitturu place. So they given some of the money to that particular people. So when they given some of the bribe or some of the money, so the few people only, they capture a Sangoli Rayanna and they given to news to British government. This like always he coming in this way, so in this routine only. So when they given this like of ideas or when this like of news they given to British government, easily they captured by Sangoli Rayanna. And they given Sangoli Rayanna and who are the followers are there and that die for Sangoli Rayanna, for them they given punishment as a hanging. So before hanging for Sangoli Rayanna, he asked one of the important request. So what is that one request? Means I want to take the blessing of our mother Kenchovva, means Queen Chennamma. So they given the permission. So with the permission, he asked the blessing of Queen Chennamma. So after that, he for also they given hanging punishment. With the smile face, he died. He become as a martyr. So still now there are so much of people, especially in North India or in Karnataka regions, still now they remembering Sangoli Rayanna because of he's one of the bravery leader. He did that much of achievements. He came in small dynasty with the support of Queen Chennamma. He did the battles and he also became headache to British government. So they also suffered so much of loss on that time of the work of Sangoli Rayanna. So still now in folk songs and still now people they are remembering Sangoli Rayanna. So after death of the Sangoli Rayanna, some other people also they started revolt against the British government because of this Kitturu want to give her Queen Chennamma so that life. But finally the British government they suppressed or they stopped the revolt. So these like we can see in Kitturu also, one of the important dynasty, they did great battle against British government. There are two important people. One is Queen Chennamma. Why she did battle? We already discussed because of her husband and son. Both also died. So that's why she adopted one of a child as a son. But the British government did not accept it. So that's why they did the battle. But she failed. So after that, Sangoli Rayanna took the leadership. He also did battle against, revolt against the British government. But finally, he also defeated. So these are the important points about Kodagu and Kitturu. So next class we can discuss about Tulunadu and Hyderabad regions.